Happy Monday, everyone, and let me say Merry Christmas to you. I know not every one of us are getting this on Monday, and maybe not all of us are even getting this around the Christmas season, but I'm at least recording this. Basically following a new series we started for December, and I hope you get a chance to see that message if you haven't. We started it yesterday, and so it's really an important message to set up today. And so there'll be a link at the end of this Devo for you to catch if you haven't seen it. But we looked at a storm in the Bible. I wanted to talk about Jesus is bigger than our storms, but I left out part of the story. And that was the story of Peter getting out of the boat. And so today I want to talk about think outside the boat. Think outside the boat. Let me read part of the passage. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them walking on the water. The fourth watch is around 3 a.m. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. It's a ghost, they said, and they cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, take courage, it is I, do not be afraid. Lord, if it's you, Peter replied, tell me to come to you on the water. Come, he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid. He began to sink. He cried out, Lord, save me. Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. You have little faith, he said. Why did you doubt? And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat worshiped him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. A lot of observations to make. I want to kind of zero in on some things Peter is doing that the other disciples are not doing, because in many ways, this is a miracle inside of a miracle. Jesus is going to walk on water, but so is one other guy who does what the other guys don't do. He asks a question the others aren't asking. And that's really what I want to say about thinking outside the boat. Sometimes we get caught up in limitations. This is for some of you that are leaders. This is for some of you that are parents or people that are just in problems. We always see are the limits we are most familiar with, and we think inside those confines. Peter's in the middle of a storm. He's in a boat that he's familiar with, but he's asking about doing something he's not familiar with. How about if I get out of the boat and come to you, Jesus, and walk on the water? It's a miracle inside of a miracle. I want to highlight this. This is one of my observations. This isn't even, because I've thought about this in the past, it felt like big, bold faith to even ask such a thing, but he starts with the word if. If it's you, Jesus. So I want to say that sometimes even the things that God wants to put in our minds or even things we bring to Jesus doesn't require that it's perfect faith, mature faith. Sometimes it's just about asking, daring to ask. I think it's safe to say this was not a safe prayer. You know, part of the story involved them crying out in fear. I've kind of joked about they probably sounded like a bunch of little girls. You know, I've got three daughters, and they used to play, and then they used to scream, and sometimes they would hurt each other. And so I kind of imagine these disciples screaming like little girls. Well, here's a guy, after he was done screaming, he started asking about a third option. That's a phrase I want you to get in your mind. Thinking outside the boat oftentimes causes you to, or requires you to think about a third option, to ask the question, what aren't other people thinking? What aren't other people asking? Sometimes we only think this or that. Well, I know this. I don't really want to do that. We've got this or that. There's a lot of times where what God's up to is the third option. Peter comes up with a third option. How about if I get out of the boat, even in the middle of the storm? That's not a safe prayer. That's a dangerous prayer in many ways. That's an uncertainty. He's stepping from uncertainty into uncertainty in many ways, but God was in it. Jesus said, come. I think about all the times where Peter is impulsive and he kind of gets out ahead of Jesus, but this time he asks the right question. If it's you, command me, one of the translations say, command me to come. He waited for a word from God. I believe this is one of the things God wants to use this devotion for today. He wants to speak to you, but sometimes he can't speak to you because we're too busy staying focused on the storm. We're so busy telling God about the limitations, even about God bailing us out. I would have thought the prayer would have been, since they were just crying out in fear, a prayer of safety. God, save me, protect me, comfort me, bring me relief. But this isn't what Peter's doing. he's eventually going to need Jesus to save him because he does lose some faith. He starts to sink, but he starts with this: Jesus, if it's you, let me go do something nobody else is doing. There's only two recorded people in history that have walked on water, Jesus and Peter. There were 11 other guys sitting in that boat, probably 5 or 6 feet away from Peter, and they missed out on this miracle. You know, I know God doesn't give us everything, but sometimes I wonder if we don't get in on things because we never asked, or we are asking the wrong question. Peter asks an interesting request that's not even all that sacred. Because think about it. The miracle of walking on water, although, a miracle, it's still more sensational than it is sacred in many ways, because nobody got fed, nobody got healed, nobody got delivered. People weren't blessed so much directly from this. This was about adventure as much as anything. And so it could be that oftentimes we're thinking, well, God only answers certain prayers. You know what? He answered this because one guy was daring to ask the question nobody else was asking. Jesus, if it's you, have me come out and walk on the water. And so if it matters to you, it matters to Jesus. If we can pray for healing, we can also pray for a raise. If we can pray for people to get saved, we can also pray about some of the dreams God's put in our heart. God's put some dreams in your heart. I wonder how many of us have let some dreams get so far on the back burner, they've just gotten cold. We've almost let them die. And I wonder if God's not stirring something up even right now in some of us to think about what we haven't been thinking about recently. God, do a new miracle. God, do something fresh. Let me step out into something that I might miss out on, that other people are missing out on, because all they're seeing is the storm. I want to walk on the water. I want to do something different. So I want to pray about that today. I believe God wants to raise some of our faith and get us to believe some things. Even imperfect faith, Jesus did not give up on Peter. Immediately, he reached out his hand, pulled him up. So come on, this is God's grace, even when faith isn't perfect. Let's be people that ask the questions people aren't asking, pray the prayers people aren't asking, so we do the things some people aren't doing. Jesus, thank you for my friends that have gathered. I believe you're stirring them up. I believe you got words to say to some of us. Lord, I know there are people truly needing to pray the salvation prayer right now. Jesus, save me. And I'm grateful, God, you reached down your hand. You're that close to us that you can save us and you can help us. And so I do pray for those that need the saving grace of God right now, not just in the spiritual sense, but in practical ways. Save people from some difficulty. Save people from doubt. Save people from sinking deeper into a problem. But I also pray that you'd help some of us to get out of the boat, do some things we haven't yet done, believe for you for some big things, trust you when you say give, that we go. When you say come, we come. And we do things that are new and fresh because we're asking new questions. So Jesus, give us insight, give us ears that hear, help us to see you in a fresh way and do things that you want us to do. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.